As a part of quality improvement in math education project, IIT Bombay and RMSA Maharashtra. I am presenting the video based PPT presentation. Topic of presentation is probability and statistics. My name is Shikre Mathaji Eknath. Registration number is C001. My school name is Motilal Kothari Vidyalay Kada, Taluka Asti. Name of the district is Bid. Introduction. Probability is an important branch of mathematics, deals with applications in statistics, science, computer science, game theory, economics, philosophy, industry, etc. In our day-to-day life, we are familiar with different experiments whose results are certain or uncertain. For example, in science, to prepare a gas in a laboratory is an experiment where the result is fixed. To find the density of particular object if mass and volume is known is an experiment where the result is fixed. In some experiments, there are more than one results. A student attended an exam, then the possible results are he will pass or fail. The results of an experiment are also called as outcomes. The outcomes of an experiment may be equally likely or not equally likely. Equally likely outcome means each outcome has same possibility. Probability is a word same as possibility, likely, fairly, probably, etc. There are common conversations like as India will have chance to win in the cricket match. Second, probably it will rain today. But we do not know what will happen exactly. Probability is the measure of happening or not happening something in the experiment. Probability is a numerical value. Today we are going to learn about random experiment and probability of events of random experiment. In this lesson, we are following three steps. Step number one, observe and explore. In this step, some videos are presenting by me and students observe the videos. The aim of showing these videos is to increase the interest of students in the related topic and to understand the probability concepts. Let us see the videos and observe the outcomes of each experiment.
Now, revenge grudge match here. Let's have a flip serve. Heads is the call.
Thank you.
the videos, and we have already recorded results or outcomes of each experiment. Now we are going to fill the table by our observations. So open your notebook and try to write these blank spaces. And if possibility of each outcome is different, then we say that the outcomes are not equally likely. Now, who can tell me for first experiment?
Head
or tail?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Why?
Because their outcomes are same.
Outcome? Not outcome. Possibility of? Yes. Each outcome is same. What about second experiment? Which are the outcomes of second experiment? Yes?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Right. Is it right?
Yes.
Yes. Good. Are they equally likely? Yes?
Yes.
Why?
Because the possibility of these,
each
result is same.
Same. Good. Now, in the wrestling game, there are two persons. Who will win the match? That is the question. So, what are the results or outcomes? Yes?
Short man, tall man, or none?
None of them. Right. There are three possible results. Okay. Are they equally likely outcomes? Yes?
No, they are not equally likely.
Why?
Because their possibility are not same.
Possibility of each outcome is? Different, not same. Okay, good. Very nice. For the fourth experiment, we have seen the clouds in the sky. Question is, it will be rain or not? What are the possibilities of this experiment? Yes?
It will be rain or not?
It will be rain
or not?
Rain or not rain? Is it right?
Yes.
Yes. Done? Are they equally likely outcomes? Yes?
No.
No. Why?
Because the possibility of each outcome is different.
Good. In the last video, we have seen how many teams?
8 teams.
Good. So, can you tell me the result of that question? Which team will win the match? IPL 2017. Who will be the winner? Which team will be the winner? So, how many outcomes will be there?
8.
So, tell me names of that outcomes one by one. Yes.
Sunrisers Hyderabad.
Yes. Second?
Mumbai.
Third?
Punjab Lions.
Fourth?
Delhi Dragons.
Next?
Rajasthan, Royal Challengers Bangalore.
These are the 8 teams or 8 outcomes of this experiment. Are they equally likely?
No.
Which outcome has more or most probability?
Mumbai.
Possibility?
Mumbai. Yes.
As your opinion. Okay? Thanks. So,
in each of the experiment, the outcomes are already known, but for some experiment, outcomes are equally likely, and in some experiment, outcomes are not equally likely. In the first and second experiment, the outcomes are equally likely, and in third, fourth and fifth experiment, the outcomes are not equally likely. Now, we are going to see step number 2. The step number 2 is define and to prove. In this step, teacher start the discussion for making the concepts in the probability. Purpose of this activity is that the students should understand concepts of random experiment, sample phase, an event, and probability of an event. Activity number 1, tossing a coin. Teacher shows a coin to the student and student tosses a coin and observes the outcome until we get head and tail. Now teacher, by using this activity, teacher explains some concepts. First concept is random experiment. As seen in this experiment, tossing of coin or tossing a coin, we have already known the outcomes of this experiment, head and tail, but we cannot predict any one of them with certainty. So such a type of experiments are called random experiment. So definition of random experiment is an experiment whose results are already known but none of them can be predicted with certainty is called a random experiment. Tossing a coin is also a random experiment.
Thumb.
Result. Observe the result. Yes?
Head.
Head. Now?
Yes.
Observe?
Tail.
Tail. Now second concept is sample phase. Just we have seen that in this experiment, head and tail are two sample points or outcomes of this experiment. Sample phase is nothing but the set of all possible outcomes of random experiment. And the sample phase is denoted by capital S. Number of outcomes in the sample phase is denoted by N of S. For example, tossing a coin, the sample phase is S in curly bracket H comma T. H denotes head and T denotes tail. And N of S is 2. Next concept is an event. Event is the set of favorable outcome getting by specific condition that taken under consideration in the random experiment. It is a subset of sample phase denoted by capital letters A, B, C, dot, dot. Number of favorable outcomes in an event A is denoted by N of A. If A is the event of getting head, then A is equal to in curly bracket H and N of A is equal to 1. Fourth concept is probability of an event. In this experiment, we observe that there are two outcomes of random experiment, that is tossing a coin, and probability of getting each outcome is same. It means that is 50% chance for each outcome. So probability of getting head is 50% is equal to 50 by 100 is equal to 1 by 2. So probability of getting head is 1 by 2 can be defined by a formula of probability of event, and that formula is probability of an event is equal to number of favorable outcomes in an event upon total number of outcomes in the sample phase of random experiment. Probability of event A is denoted by P of A. for event of getting head, probability of A is equal to n of A upon n of S. N of A is 1 and n of A is 2. So probability of event A is 1 by 2. So these are the some concepts. For the same experiment, there are other events. Suppose event B is getting tail. So B consists only tail. So n of B is 1 and probability of B is n of B upon n of S, that is 1 by 2. Event C getting head or tail. So C consists H and T. So n of C is 2. So probability of C is n of C upon n of S, means 2 by 2 is equal to 1. Event D is getting head and tail. So D is equal to, in curly bracket, no sample point. So n of D is equal to 0. So probability of D is equal to n of D upon n of S is equal to 0 by 2. That is 0.
Second activity. Observe here. We have 3 balls. And I am dropping each ball in the jar. Observe the colors of the balls. So how many balls contain in the jar?
Three
balls. What are the colors of balls?
Red, green, and blue.
Now, activity is that we have to take one ball from the jar randomly. Don't see the ball and then take out. Without observing the ball, you have to take one ball from the jar. So we are going to do that activity. So please come here and take out one ball from the jar without observing. So this is a red ball. So, sit down please. Next student may come here. Yes, who? This is a green ball. Sit down please. So what are the possible outcomes of this experiment and how many?
Three.
And which are them?
Red ball, green ball, or blue ball.
Possibility of each outcome is same.
Okay.
In second activity, drawing a ball from a jar containing 3 balls. One is red and other balls are blue and green. In this experiment, random experiment is drawing the ball from the jar. S is equal to sample space, red ball, blue ball, green ball. It contains 3 balls. So n of S is 3. If we take event A is of getting a red ball, then A consists red ball and n of A is equal to 1. So P of A is equal to n of A upon n of S is equal to 1 by 3. If we take event B as not getting a red ball, then B is equal to, in curly bracket, B, blue ball, green ball. N of B is equal to 2. So probability of B is n of B upon n of S, that is 2 by 3. In this way, we can find the probability of any event of any random experiment. Now we go to the third step, apply and evaluate. In this step, students can find the probability of events of random experiment by using the formula of probability of event. Just seen in the last step. Now read the question number 1. A dice thrown find the probability of getting an even number on the upper face. So in this question, the experiment is a die is thrown and the event is of getting an even number. We can find the probability of this event as a die is thrown, then S is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, N of S is 6, event A is getting an even number A, then A is equal to 2, 4, 6. So N of A is equal to 3. Probability of event A is P of A is equal to N of A upon N of S, that is 1 by 2. Second question. If the coin are tossed simultaneously, then find the probability of not getting head. So answer is as like this. Student will give the answer. Experiment is two coins are tossed simultaneously, then S is equal to HH, HT, TH, TT, N of S is 4, event A not getting head, so A contained, TT is the only one outcome, so N of A is 1 and probability of event A is 1 by 4. Then question 3, a card is drawn at random from the well-shuffled pack of 52 cards. Find the probability of getting a diamond card. Answer. Experiment is a card is drawn at random from the well-shuffled pack of 52 cards. So S consists 52 cards. N of S is equal to 52. In this question, event A is getting a diamond card. So A is equal to 13 cards and N of A is equal to 13. Probability of event A is P of A is equal to N of A upon N of S is equal to 13 by 52 is equal to 1 by 4. Now there are three questions, question 4, question 5, question 6 for solving these questions. Students should try. Question 4 is, two dice are thrown, find the probability of the following events. The sum of the numbers on their upper faces is divisible by 9 and the sum of the numbers of the upper faces is at the most 2. Question 5, find 5 coins are tossed simultaneously, find the probability of getting head on the middle coin. Question 6, the measure of rectangular ground are 28 meter and 22 meter. And the radius of the circle is 7 cm. An helicopter is landing on the ground. What is the probability of landing helicopter in the circular area? This example can be solved by using formula. Probability of landing helicopter in the circular area is equal to area of circle upon area of rectangle. So, students can solve such a type of examples by using probability concept. And there is end of this lesson. Thanking for all.